More people are starting to travel again, and not only does that mean they are flying to another city, but renting a car once you get there. For one woman who recently took a trip to San Francisco, renting a car turned into a month-long ordeal. Our Jennifer Krause has a look at what to do so the same thing doesn't happen to you.
It was wonderful.
When Emily Walters and her husband visited San Francisco recently, they decided to spend a day driving down the California coast.
We went to Santa Cruz and had lunch and some seafood and saw some of the beach cities and had a great time.
Walters had found a deal online for a one-day car rental through Hertz.
We got a little economy car. We were in a little Chevy Spark.
They were supposed to pick up the car from the Hertz office in a downtown San Francisco hotel and then drop it back off there later that night using the hotel's valet service. And Walters says there wasn't a problem.
We pull up and a uniformed valet comes up to me and says, are you returning a car? I said, yes, I'm returning a car. Here you go.
Until several days later, after she'd flown back to Nashville and got a call from an investigator working for Hertz.
I'm calling about the car that never got returned. And I said, oh my goodness. I said, I returned it on the 2nd, the same day, and I have ample proof. I told her, I said, I've got it all here. I've got the valet claim check and everything else. And she told me, this happens all the time.
Hertz did finally find the car, but that wasn't the end of it.
And the next thing I know, I get a bill for the balance.
How much were they charging you?
Nearly $600. A $60 estimate comes $600 because they claim I delivered it on the 9th.
I'm shaking my head in disbelief.
Tonya Fitzpatrick runs a travel media company and frequently writes and speaks about travel.
We're in what I call a car apocalypse right now. You know, the demand is incredibly high and the supply is very low. And so a lot of these car rental agencies are churning their cars. They are not necessarily being cleaned properly. For the next driver, they're just kind of, you know, thrown out the door. And that could very well have been what happened to the couple in Nashville, is that their car, because it was just a one-day rental, their car was sent out right away.
That's why Fitzpatrick says consumers need to be proactive.
And what I always advise people, other travelers, is to do what we do as travel professionals, and that's document everything.
So when you pick up a car, do you walk around with your phone and take pictures of everything?
I do, and I try to do it, or we try to do it with the agent.
Fitzpatrick says that protects you so you're not later charged for, say, damage to the car you didn't cause. And she says don't stop documenting.
I would certainly get evidence, proof of return of the car, even if it's a photograph of you giving the keys to the agent and it's not easily discernible or you don't have documentary or photographic evidence of that, it becomes your word against the car rental agency.
I have ample proof that I delivered it on the 2nd.
For Walters, it took more than a month to convince Hertz to reverse that nearly $600 charge.
Last week, I literally spent 2 full days trying to reclaim this money. And it's not a fortune, but it's also not an insignificant amount.
She remembers thinking it was funny when a Hertz representative asked her.
He said, did you take any pictures when you returned the car? I said, do y'all tell people that you should have photographic evidence of when you return a car?
But now she realizes that's just the smart thing to do.
I think it has to be this way, and it's unfortunate, isn't it?
Travel expert Tonya Fitzpatrick recommends hanging on to all your documentation and receipts until you see the charges come through on your credit card and you agree with them. She also recommends that you pay for your rental car with a credit card rather than a debit card, because that'll give you more protection in case you decide to dispute the charges. Jennifer Krause, News Channel 5 Investigates.